Movie review. Share and joy. This is Movie Uncover. I am James. Today, we'll talk about a great film with dark humor. Getting home, in the noisy bus station's small restaurant. Two people are drinking, lying motionless on the table is Lau Liu. After the meal, they boarded a bus from Shenzhen to Chongqing. The bus was full of passengers. Bus stopped at the side of the road and let the passengers go pee. Everyone was on the side of the road. One side for each gender. Everyone got out of the bus. Except for Lau Liu, who was wearing a hat and sunglasses and leaning against the window. Soon, the women were not happy because Lau Liu is lying on the window to peek at their pee. A while, women rushed to the bus to settle a score. Lao Zhao rushed over to relieve the siege. Then came the bandits, where the bandits swarmed the passengers, and they were terrified. Seek riches and honor in the midst of danger, evil will rise up in one's brave. Notice R, now start robbing R, you now hurry to pay. No money, hurry to borrow money R, don't let me waste time R. The robber leader is well armed, with a detector to scan one by one. Even women's bras and men's crutches. Lao Zhao did not dare to play slick, but also honestly took out his 500 and Lao Liu's 5,000. Just Lao Zhao had to remind the robber leader, the 5,000 is the dead man's money. Cannot take. Under questioning, Lao Zhao explained the truth. Lao Liu has died, disguised as a drunk to get on the bus. He had a bad life. Not a work injury, but drinking to death. The boss was kind enough to give 5,000 yuan to his wife and children, all relying on him to support them. Lao Zhao must give this money to their families. Lao Zhao also promised to let him buried at hometown and rest in peace. The bandit leader listened, thumbs up, and praised him for his righteousness. He also poured the looted property to Lao Zhao. He said to give all this money to Lao Zhao. No one is allowed to take back. But after they left, passengers have gone up to get their things back, yelling that dead bodies have infectious diseases. Cannot stay in a bus with dead bodies. Not expecting that, Lao Zhao denied the robbers, did not get praised, but was driven off the bus. Lao Zhao carried the body of Lao Liu on the road, step by step. He wanted to stop a car, but no one was willing to help. Finally, he disguised Lao Liu as an urgent need for assistance. Only then hitched a ride on a farm tractor. Enthusiastic farmers took them to the hospital, asked him to help register. Lao Zhao carried Lao Liu on his back and ran away. In order to save money, he found a cheap hotel to stay overnight. Heard that the driver Lao Hu is going to Chongqing. It hit the idea of a ride. Unexpectedly, Lao Hu did not give a good face, but also drank up Lao Zhao's wine. At night, Lao Zhao's money was stolen. He is anxious, said want to call the police. But when someone really took out the phone, Lao Zhao panicked. All right, I do not want the money. Lao Zhao carried Lao Liu continued the road. Did not expect that Lao Hu drove up, said to give him a ride. Lao Zhao cannot help but feel that this Lao Hu is interesting. The money is gone. You drive me instead. Lao Hu asked him why he was afraid of the police. Lao Zhao told him the truth, and he did not ask more questions. On the road, Lao Zhao hummed a little song. Lao Hu suddenly slammed on the brakes, and then he pounced on Lao Zhao, choking him. How can you sing this song? Lao Zhao was terrified. Then, he fell on the steering wheel and bawled. He cursed the little slut. A snotty, tearful story about the sad past. It turns out that 3 years ago, he met a woman when he was driving a truck. She also sang this song. He was fascinated. Every time he would go to take care of her business. And then they got together. He vowed after driving for 300,000 kilometers, he would marry her. But the woman saw him moving closer, without saying a word, and slipped away. Lao Zhao comforted him. What is called love is being fucking tossed to death. Since you love her, you have driven 300,000 kilometers, and then drive another 300,000 kilometers to find her back. The man heard, Enlightened, he stepped on the gas and set off again. Until the sunset, he parked the car at the side of the road. Lao Zhao urged him to make sure to find her. Lao Hu replied with a smile, "You must send him to the place." With that, they said goodbye to each other and embarked on their respective journeys. Lao Zhao carried Lao Liu walking hard along the country road, suddenly came across a villager in a funeral service. After the money was stolen, he had been hungry all day. He disguised Lao Liu as a scarecrow in the field and then followed the funeral procession to the owner's house. People invited to mourning cry like ghosts and wolves, but not a drop of tears. But the more Lao Zhao cried at the funeral, the sadder he became. He also finally ate a full meal. While eating, the old man lying in the coffin suddenly sat next to him. Lao Zhao a little bewildered. The old man hastened to explain that he did not die, but because he has no children, afraid that when he left the time it's too quiet and cold, he invited some people to come over to act. To do a funeral, to feel the atmosphere in advance. He asked Lao Zhao, "Why are you crying so badly?" Lao Zhao recalled the encounter along the way. The old man listened and felt compassion. He took out some pills, said it can slow down the decay of the body, but also gave Lao Zhao a cart, which allows him to save some energy. In this way, Zhao used the cart to drag the body to continue the road. On the road, Lao Zhao encountered an ox cart. Lao Zhao dragged the cart and raced with the cows on the road. But how can an old man run over the ox cart? At this time, a young man riding a bicycle came to help, so that Lao Zhao finally overtake the cow. The young man invited Lao Zhao to have coffee and said he was challenging himself to ride alone to Tibet. The young man's energy also infected Lao Zhao, since the young man can ride to Tibet. How can Lao Zhao not pull the cart to Chongqing? Happiness didn't last. There is no brakes when going downhill. And he rolled into the ditch with the cart. He was not hurt. But the small cart has fallen apart. Looking around, not far ahead, there was a driver who fell even harder, with injuries at the head, is sitting on the tires smoking. Anyway, his car has been scrapped. Lao Zhao asked him for the tire. He wrapped Lao Liu with straw into the tire and just pushed the tire. Again, full of energy, strutting with head held high, with the wheel on the flat ground is indeed a lot more comfortable. But probably, every time, happiness just for 5 minutes. Once to the uphill road, Lao Zhao cannot take it. He was tired of bending down and gasping for breath. Hard to push the tire up the slope. Just a breath moment. The tire rolled down at speed. Lao Zhao shouted, "It's over. It's over." While rushing to catch up. And finally the tire rolled down a steep slope and fell into the ravine. If a living person has been killed, in the end, he had to carry Lao Liu. Lao Zhao carried him to a dirt slope. Want to change shoes with him to wear. In the insoles of Lao Liu, found his private money. A total of 430 yuan. Lao Zhao was so happy and disgusted with Lao Liu, with his money to rent a truck to send him back. The money counted as Lao Zhao borrowed from Lao Liu. Then, he hid Lao Liu into the bushes and went to town to find a truck, but also went to the roadside restaurant for a full meal. After eating and drink, the boss asked for 600 yuan. The boss looked fierce. Lao Zhao can only obediently pay. He understand that he was cheated. He just start walking. Was called from behind. In the original 600, 200 is fake money. He rushed to take out the rest of the money. Look at all the fake money. Lao Zhao has always felt that the construction site boss has a conscience. What the fuck is this conscience? Did not have time to explain. The restaurant boss slapped over. The boss let the minions teach him a good lesson. Let him spit out what he ate. After returning to the grove, he burned the fake money to Lao Liu. Tears fell. He could only bury Lao Liu here. He used a stick in the woods to plan a pit. After plowing, he lay in to try. He had been forced to end here. Looking at the blue sky, white clouds, pines, beautiful plants overhead, Lao Zhao felt that this place is so comfortable. If he can also be buried here, he will not have to suffer and can go to heaven with Lao Liu in peace. So he tied a large stone in the tree, trying to smash himself to death. But then when the pitch came over, he instinctively dodged. Finally, he was smashed by the stone at the back and fainted. When he woke up, Lao Zhao had been saved by a family of beekeepers. After listening to Lao Zhao's story, the woman took off her veil. She was disfigured by an accident. The man was heartbroken and decided to take his wife with him to keep bees. so that she could move freely when no one was around. After eating, the children read poems with his mother. With renewed confidence in life, through the rolling rapeseed fields, until evening, when the beekeeper finally dropped them off in town, they shook hands and said goodbye, silently sending their blessings to each other. Lao Zhao walked bewildered, suddenly heard the noise coming from the small hair salon, walked straight in, and put Lao Liu on the bed. The girl tried to drive him away, but he gave a flutter and knelt down. He heard the girl with a northeastern accent. They were from the same town. He wanted to beg the girl to give Lao Liu a makeup, sort out the remains. The girl heard a dead man, scared and let them go. At this time, it happened that a patrol police car drove over. The police saw from afar Lao Zhao was talking to the girl. When he walked in, the girl was washing Lao Zhao's hair. The police questioned him. The girl rushed to help round up. She said Lao Zhao is her cousin's uncle. To go back home, just passing through here, drink until down. The police listened to her words, dispelled his doubts. But the police spoke all the expression of concern for the girl. Finally he left. Lao Zhao finally relieved. The girl felt that Lao Zhao must be a good man. And in quite hard situation, she eventually helped with the makeup and sent them out of the store. Lao Zhao walked down the street with Lao Liu on his back and ran into the police officer again. He insisted on sending him. Lao Zhao was too gracious to refuse, so he had to get into the car. In casual conversation, Lao Zhao gradually relaxed. Since the girl called him uncle, he also saw that the police officer was interested in the girl. He is a good man. Lao Zhao intends to set them up. It will be in the name of the uncle entrusted the girl to him, hoping he take good care of her. The police kept sending them to the station. Early next morning, Lao Zhao hid Lao Liu in the cement pipe. Then, he got on the blood collection truck, ready to donate blood for a free lunch. But because he had previously had hepatitis B, the nurse said that his blood could not be used. And Zhao asked for a bit of food. While eating, while hanging out, Lao Zhao was again targeted by blood traffickers. He was coaxed and tricked, and finally came to the blood station. Lao Zhao here met a scavenger sister. The sister said she came over every 3 months. Once 500 yuan. Lao Zhang had hepatitis B. Blood is dirty. Donating it will definitely harm people. Listen to what she said. Get up and go. What a coincidence. At this time the police arrived outside. The people in the legal blood station were caught on the police car. The blood sellers were also sent to the relief center. Everyone gobbled their meals and listened to the director talking on stage about the rescue policy. The director also said that this evening they would have a gala. Let's get lively. Afterwards, everyone took a hot bath. The woman said she has submitted a program to perform a double act with Lao Zhao. After the party started, some talented disabled people performed their programs. When Lao Zhao and the woman came on stage, two of them turned the director's talking section into a double act, which made the people laugh. Immediately afterwards, Lao Zhao sang a song, "I Want to Have a Home." The simple yet true lyrics hit every heart away from home. The woman sang and sang and sorrow came from it. Tears could not stop falling. Lao Zhao heard her crying. The voice of an owl made her laugh. After they finished the show with tears in their eyes, the two sat down to talk freely, and Lao Zhao told her his story. After sending Lao Liu back, he was going back home, old and tired, and the woman opened up about what happened to her. Her son is here at the Southwest University of Finance and Economics. Her face is full of happiness and pride. However, remembering his son's attitude, smile on his face disappeared. At the beginning, he sent money to his son once a month. Then one day, her son told her not to send it in person. Too much trouble. Let her transfer the money. No need to go to school. So almost 2 years, mother and son did not meet. The woman said with tears have been playing in the eyes. Lao Zhao listened, angry. As the saying goes, children do not mind their mothers are ugly. Dogs do not mind their families are poor. She collects rags and sells blood for her son to study. But her son is too ashamed of her. Not to mention college students. Even a professor have to recognize their own mother. Such a son cannot be ignored, must be properly educated. The woman said. The child's father died early. They have not been easy over the years. The son is spoiled some. If her son has a future, she does not care much. After a long silence, Zhao asked her if she had considered a companion. The woman said she had thought about it. If she could meet her destiny. Lao Zhao stammered and said. We both have similar conditions. Look at me. Can I be competent? I am speaking from my heart. Just now when we both performed the show, I was holding you. My heart was jumping. It's been a few years since. The woman was moved by his words. In fact, her heart is also thumping just now. Lao Zhao said that he would come back to her after finishing the matter, and he would treat her well. The woman said that over the years, it was the first time she listened to such heartwarming words. Gave his 400 yuan. But the money from collecting rags and selling blood, Lao Zhao refused to take. Don't you have to come back to me. I'll be right here waiting for you. With these words, Lao Zhao was relieved to get on the road. But when he went back, the workers were lifting cement pipes. Lao Zhao secretly climbed into the car and hitched to the site. Then, he took Lao Liu and hitched a ride on the construction truck. He is in good spirits, sitting on the roof of the car, like a spring breeze. Couldn't help but recite the poem. If my hometown is a big road, I am a car, I run. How happy I am. If my hometown is a big tree, I am a leaf, I dance. How happy I am. Happy sometimes is really simple. Really. Sometimes is really simple. I guess the journey was really hard. And this time, it was finally easy to take. Perhaps it's because you've found a companion. The next life can be considered to have a head start. After getting off the car, Lao Zhao continued to carry Lao Liu to continue the journey. As before, waving to stop the car, none of the drivers passing by were willing to carry. A bus did stop. But Lao Zhao took a look at the car as students. Afraid to scare the children, he had to give up. Lao Zhao did not say a word and walked forward, not knowing how much time has passed. Lao Zhao exhausted and continued to walk. Slowly, there are many cars are parked on the side of the road, and they were the same people who refused to drive Lao Zhao. The front collapse. No one can pass. Overworked and increasingly numb, he just kept walking along the road, and finally he collapsed. When he woke up, he found himself lying in a hospital bed. There was an old policeman standing by. He did not give him a hard time. Just after finding out the cause of death of Lao Liu, told Lao Zhao cannot transport the body privately. The body could be given to a nearby funeral home for cremation in situ. The matter has come to this. Lao Zhao had to do as he was told. But he did not expect that. The cheapest urn is more than 400. Lao Liu's life is worth 5,000, all fake money. But turned into ashes. Need the real money. Lao Liu's body was cremated. Lao Zhao silently holding the ashes. People live a lifetime. At the end of the day is only this small box of white bones. The old policeman himself drove them home. Crossing with the ferryman. Telling them that the place will soon be impounded with water and built a dam. Residents have moved to the city. When they arrived at Lao Liu home, the place has become a ruin. The land where he was meant to be buried. Without a home, the broken door of the house is written with the son to his father. Dad, we moved away. We have been looking for you, but never heard from you. We know we were wrong. We ask for your forgiveness. This will always be your home. We are waiting. After reading, Zhao rubbed his hazy eyes. His home was gone. And how to return to his roots. Getting home. 1,000 strange things. All kinds of people. Through the eyes of people at the bottom of society, it shows the human condition with dark humor. The righteous robbers, unrighteous passengers, the enthusiastic farmer, the old man who invites people to cry for funerals, the young man riding to Tibet, the unscrupulous shopkeeper who takes advantage of people, the boss who gave fake money, the beekeeping families, the kind-hearted hairdresser, the businessman who cheats people of their blood, and the woman who sells blood for her son. These stories, both sad and happy, tell the story of the changes in Chinese society. Through what Lao Zhao sees and hears along the way, he shows the moral values of Chinese people. Since 2000, we have witnessed the rapid development of China's economy. We have witnessed the progress of technology and the rise of cities. But at the same time, we have also witnessed the slow fading of human feelings. We have witnessed the materialization of love. Witnessed the collapse of more and more moral concepts. Our previous generation believed in kindness, honesty, simplicity, and righteousness. A promise of 1,000 gold. If there is no way to turn these things into cash, then it is pedantic, dull, or even not smart enough. We get what we think is the maximum benefit, and enjoy the least amount of pleasure. We seem to have a hard time shouting out loud that, how happy I am. Like Lao Zhao, if there is anything else we should praise as society evolves, I think that there are still some people who are holding on to something. It is this almost foolish perseverance that makes our society more warm-hearted. Those people who hold on to their principles and beliefs at every corner are every one of those standing silently by the roadside when there is light in the night. We do not feel that the light is valuable and even feel that he interferes with our vision, but when there is no light in the darkness, we can understand the meaning of light. I hope that soon, we can all become a light to illuminate a section of the road. Well, that's it for today's commentary. Please subscribe, click the like button and share this video. Movie Uncover. See you next time.